for the stay of people there and the community food and all that. And in the ashram you must be, because ashram is the place where you really develop that sense of cooperation, sense of collectivity, sense of roughing it out. And this so-called comfort of life, which is just fossilized, will release a little more. So that is a possibility in America very much. England was, I must say, the English are the greatly blessed people. Now we have 7 houses in London, which the co-op has given us about free. Can you imagine? So they have no problem. So every country has its own style, and accordingly we should try to solve the problem. Like France has some problems, and we are trying to solve that problem. So every one of you should try to find out a way and method of establishing these ashrams first. That's the first thing. With that ashram, if you want, you can start a shop or something, or a restaurant, whatever you want. But it should not be a thing done through Sahaja Yoga. It's your own. It's your private thing. You do it the way you like. But people can donate money for the ashram, and you should pay back rent religiously. And that is one thing we must understand, that in money matters, you should not play any hanky-panky at all. That one has to pay so dearly, that I'm shocked sometimes. So in money matters, one should not. Because I know of some people who did this, and they have suffered a lot. And I don't want you to suffer physically. And a person met with an accident who did that. So he was saved, but he lost his leg and things like that can happen. So I would not like you, I don't want to frighten you. But do not try to play about with this religious money. Be very honest and meticulous. Do not waste money. It's very dangerous. It will affect your parents, it will affect your children, it will affect everyone. So be very, very careful on that point. I have to tell you extremely with great care and caution. That is, you don't understand, because auspiciousness you don't understand. It is inauspicious to play with God's work. This is the work of God. For me what? Everything is mine. I mean, if I take away everything that you have, I am not committing any sin, because I am sinless. But still, how meticulous I am with money, you can ask people. Every pie that I spend of yours is recorded. Of course, mine I don't, because that will embarrass me. But every account, everything is recorded, if I spend the money. And I see to it that I pay back. That's what you have to be careful about, that don't play about with money. That's one thing I must warn you, because this is really, you have entered into the kingdom of God. And the laws of kingdom of God are to be observed. Now we can say that, alright, if you are not paying income tax to the government, doesn't matter in Sahaja Yoga much. Really, I've said, doesn't matter. Though I would always like to pay. But it doesn't matter so much. But if you don't look after the money that is collected for God, then there is danger. So be careful. Secondly, you have to be very careful about your chastity in surgery. Very important. Your chastity is extremely important. And you have to preserve your chastity more than anything else. Because once you lose your chastity, you will lose all your powers. So that is a very important thing. Keep your eyes on the Mother Earth when you walk. Try to train your eyes, be on the Mother Earth. Treat every woman as your sister. That's how you will work it out, then the things will come back. Because that's the power of Ganesha, which we must achieve, in a sense. And it will come, it works out. Ganesha, once awakened within you, gives you that power. So try to understand this. For that, you don't have to exert much, because you will see God helps you so much that you control everything in such a manner that you enjoy your chastity, you enjoy your generosity, you enjoy all your virtue. Anything extreme must be avoided in such a way. Like I told people that we don't believe in jogging, in the sense that people should not jog too much. But it is not for the people who are needing a little exercise, they should do. The people who are left-sided must do some exercises. And the people who are right-sided should take some more rest. Give rest to your brain, mainly the brain. If you think too much, give up thinking. Right-sided people should give up thinking, less of aggressiveness, less of organizing things, organizing others, better organize themselves. So that's how it will help you on the right side. And the left-sided people should take some exercise and should put more effort to plan out and think, so there is a balance. But again, one should not go to extreme. Once you come to the center, when you are in thoughtless, you just don't do anything. God is looking after you, He is thinking for you. He is the one who is planning. So you don't have to worry on that. So it works out this way, that to correct yourself, to give yourself a balance a little bit, the left has to go to the right and right has to go to the left. But when you come to the center, you steady yourself there, work it out, and then you start growing. The growth is only when you are in the center, neither on the right nor on the left. When you are in the center, the growth starts. And that is how everything will work out in such a beautiful manner. You yourself will be surprised how you are growing. This is the one point. And the another which I must tell you, very important, is this: the new people who come now, you do not know how far you have gone from the day you had started serving. You have grown too much. It grows very fast. Especially with the puja, suddenly you will find you are pushed into it. Puja is something that really pushes people into it. And you are surprised how I am changed, how everything has worked out, how it's happened. But it is. When that such a thing happens to you, you must remember that others haven't had this opportunity of the puja. They haven't been in Sahaja Yoga so far. They have just now got realization. So what should we do? We should be kind, compassionate, considerate, forgiving to them, and try to bring them along. Anything, if you said gently, will be very much appreciated. Even money matters, I find, if you are a gentle person, if nobody feels hurt, because people want to give, but you should be gentle. So the gentleness must be used all the time for telling about Sahaja Yoga. The gentler you are, the greater you are in Sahaja Yoga. Like a tree, when it is laden with fruits, it droops down. It becomes humble. In the same way, when you have got the fruits of Sahaja Yoga, you humble down. That's what one should know. The humility is one of the signs of yoga. And you'll be surprised the way you'll be able to manage the play about with your vibration. It's joyous, absolutely. And you'll feel your own powers within yourself. And a person who is powerful can only be compassionate. Weak persons cannot have compassion. What is the non-violence of a weak person? He has to be jolly well non-violent. But a strong person, because he's so strong, well, he's not bothered. There's a Chinese story, an interesting one, that there were two cocks who were going to be fighting in a cock's fight, as they have it in China, and the king wanted to train them up. So somebody told him that there's a saint who will train up these cocks very well. So he went down to the saint and asked him, can you make them powerful? He said, yes, I can. So after a month, when he returned, he saw these cocks were standing just like this. He said, what? They don't even move. He said, that's why, because they have so much power. So they carried these two cocks to the arena, and in the arena, what do they find? That everybody was fighting the cock, and these stood up like this, and all the cocks got frightened with their majesty, and they all ran out. So that's why, when you are a steady person, people know you are steady, they understand that you are great. And they just look at you and they know you are there. The steadiness. The agitated person is a nervous person. A person who is frightened is also a nervous person. But a person who stands up in steadiness is the one who is a Sahaja Yogi. So I would request you to build up your steadiness first. Do not criticize others. Do not also get angry with yourself. Guilt is sinful. To feel guilty is sinful in Sahaja Yoga. Forget the past. Forget the past. And that's how you all will rise higher and higher. You'll grow. Just see this tree. Supposing this tree is on a wobbly ground, it won't grow. Will it grow? Or if it is on a tilted ground, will it grow properly? How does it grow? When it is in a steady situation. So, Sahaja Yoga being the living process, you have to steady yourself. That's very important, steady yourself. And that steadiness will make you grow faster and faster. And you'll be amazed at yourself. As it is, you must be amazed that you have come into a wonderful world yourself. Enjoy! There's no frivolousness, but mirth and frolicking of innocence. So that's how we are going to organize our next program. With respect, self-respect. People should not say that Americans are no good. We have to have our self-respect. We have to show that we are Sri Krishna's special people and his 16,000 powers are to be awakened here, and we are not going to beg from anyone. Why should anybody help us? And that's how we'll work it out. But I don't want you to sell your ornaments, sell your houses, do this, do that, nothing of the kind. You'll get it. You'll get everything. You'll get the money. You are just an instrument. You are just an instrument, but be an instrument of honesty. If you are a miserly person, neither you'll get money nor you'll give. It's a vicious circle. So any other question now? Somebody wanted to see me? Lori? Where is she? What do you want to say? These insects at least are sincere. We don't have them in India anywhere. I've never heard this sound anywhere. You went to India, did you hear this? First I was not understanding, I thought something wrong with my ears.
And to stop the neighbors noise is coming.
Huh?
So you got hard to hear the neighbors.
They must be all disturbed, I'm sure. Otherwise, why should they make so much noise? I can't understand. Insects also don't make so much noise. All the time, continuously. You can't tell it, Tatiana.
They like locusts.
The
message is the
American bug. They make a lot of noise.
Someone named Rama. Rama. Yeah. No, you can sit there on the ground. Alright. I would suggest that put your left hand to the stand and right hand on the madana. Can you put it down for her a little bit? Or can you have any other candle for her?
A small candle.
Those who have been to gurus, raise your hand. Most of those, they feel guilty. Is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah, she has been, yes. 6. Ladies who have been to Guru, please don't feel guilty. Raise your hand. Alright. Now this is the way to do it. Those who have been to gurus, whether you are thin or fat makes no difference. You put your hand to the there khali chawa. No, still put it down. Khali chawa will be like that. So far away. माझं काय म्हणणं तेच खाली ठेवलं तर होईल जस्ट सी द मूवमेंट ऑफ द कॅन्डल यू सी आज देर इज नो एअर कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस साईड कूल इज कमिंग Put your thumb. Full hand. Open full hand. Now what is the mantra? Mantra is I am my own guru. Are they hatching now?
It takes 17 years for these eggs to come out. 17 years for the eggs to come out. And they're hatching today.
Come out means what?
Well, they've been hatching. They've been around.
This is, they are 17 years after they're hatching now.
Yes. These, the ones that are doing noise now, were laid 17 years ago.
सगळं आवडतं नाही आवडतं नाही सगळं
सतरा वर्ष
17th इयर मस्ट बी बिकॉज ऑफ द 16 इयर्स ऑफ श्रीकृष्णाचं आवडतं आहे श्रीकृष्ण अँड देन दे आर क्वायट इज इट
When they're not reading.
Oh, then they're quiet. For 17 years they're quiet. But how many years do they do like this?
One year.
So this is the year they are doing.
In this area. Each area, they'll be hatching every year in different areas. This year, this area.
There'll be more here next year.
Huh?
There'll be more here next year. They come every year.
For the eggs, they come every year, but the eggs hatch every 17.
But in France, it's every day, like so.
Huh?
In France, every day.
Really?
South France, in Provence, it's every day, like so. It's a folklore, it's written in the book, it's a cultural fact.
Just in India, you don't have them at all. I've never heard, it's so silent. It's so silent, especially if you go in a forest in India. And when there is a tiger sitting somewhere, so silent, immediately you can feel the silence, the presence, because he's the king, you see. See the protocol. Not that he is going to hurt anyone. He may be eating his prey, sitting down. But about a 1 mile area, it's pin drop silent. Even birds don't twitter, nothing. And immediately you know there's a tiger somewhere. See the presence of tiger itself. And when the tiger dies in a forest, actually they weep as if, you know, everyone wails out. You can feel it, the tiger is there. Better now.
But when a guru comes in a town, the dogs are not more are silent. When some gurus come in some towns in India, the dogs are silent.
How? What did you say?
Dog bark karat nahi manto.
Kute?
Kutre, guru wala ki India mali asa manto to kutre. I don't know.
What is it?
Which part of India?
It was in Bihar.
What happened? Yes, sir.
They're from...
I called on it. I didn't follow.
It's near from... what is it called? Bodna? No. How
do you
place for Buddha? Buddha
has enlightened. Yes. Bodhi. Yes. What happened?
Bodh Gaya.
Bodh Gaya, yeah.
And there some people come, some the dogs,
Ducks do not bark.
Somebody came from Damshala. Maybe you know who it is.
What did he say?
He makes conference, he makes crying, blessing, and thousands of people came.
He is the worst of all.
Yeah.
I have to.
Before you go, why don't you, before you go, 5 minutes, why don't you think for mother?
I'm going to perform.
All right. So when you come back, what time will you be back? All right, I'll be here. Now, you see, this Dalai Lama is a fellow who once came to dinner with Lal Bahadur Shastri, who was the Prime Minister, and my husband was his secretary. And as his wife never used to go to any dinner party, I was the one blasted. So, Shastriji was a realized soul and he knew about me perhaps. So I was sitting next to me, so hot, just like an oven, I couldn't bear it, you see. I thought I'll develop blister. So I became very sort of fidgety. So Shastriji said, are you feeling hot with this man? I'm also feeling. In Hindi he says, I said, yes, he's very hot. He said, all right. So he asked one Sardarji Vihar Swaran Singh, who was a foreign minister. He asked him to sit in between me and Sardarji was also feeling rather uncomfortable with this fellow. So that's what Dalai Lama was. But what shocked me the most was, when I went to China, they showed us the wealth of Dalai Lama. It was such a lot. His plate was real gold. His cup was real gold. He used to take bath in a big thing like that, made of real gold. I mean, if you see the value of the thing, I cannot tell you how much it was. And diamonds and pearls and emeralds, everything. Such a lot. I would say it was more than Pope. Of course, Pope was much more. But still, he had all kinds of things, supposed to be a sannyasi. And he used to drink, because lots of drinking things there were, all made of gold. And Pali, it was written, their names were written, so Chinese could not have manufactured it. They have been accumulating it from those poor Tibetans. And Tibetans are so poor, they don't even have proper clothes to clothe themselves. They cover themselves up with gunny bags. And from them, they used to extract this money, take all the money from them, all kinds of things. And that's how they have become so rich. And I was amazed to see. And I verified it, because may have been a propaganda, but it was not so, because Pali and everything, and it was all quite old pieces, and all of them were there. So this is what this horrible Dalai Lama is. He's just talking big things, you see. He's the biggest liar that you could think. He has nothing to do with Buddha. He's just anti-Buddha. You have to outwit them.
Would you speak a little about why Mother Earth has created precious gems and what the real use of them is, what the proper precious use of them is?
She's a generous lady. And she wants to give you everything that she has. And she gives you gems and all the chakras that are within us have a gem with it. Yes. So you know the chakras, what gems they have? Do you know or not?
No.
All right. In Muladhara, you have the coral. I think it's written somewhere.
Coral.
Then with the Swadhisthana, you have the topaz, the yellow topaz. The Guru Chimut. Then, with the Nabi, is the emerald. Then with the heart, is the ruby. Vishuddhi is the blue sapphire. That's why in India nobody wears it. It's very dangerous, you know. Krishna can play tricks with it. Then with Agya is the diamond. And with the Sastrara is the pearl. So if you have a problem of a particular chakras, if you get a good thing like that, you can wear. Amethyst is one of the stones which is actually Mahamaya stone, we can call it. Because amethyst changes its color.
Yeah.
Changes its color. And it's from ruby. It changes into blue. So it's a Mahamaya. It is the combination of the heart chakra and the Vishuddhi chakra. It's the Mahamaya. Vishnumaya. I mean, every cannot go on to details. But most of them have some meaning.
Lapis
lazuli. It's not a precious stone. It's not a very precious stone, lapis lazuli. It's not a very precious stone.
I heard it was a healing stone.
Huh?
A healing stone.
Lapis lazuli is a healing stone. Because it represents the blood of the saint. That's why. Saint blood is represented in lapis lazuli. Come. What's the matter with your hand?
I have, in my hand, I had some stitches in the hand, but they are out now. Hmm. And I actually could take the bandage off.
No, sorry. That's not my problem. I can work out through bandage.
No, but my problem is I sent a lot of depression.
Huh?
Depression. And I've been in and out of the hospital for the last 2 years. And there's just nothing I can do about it. So I wonder if you...
That's easily curable. Your depression can be easily cured. No problem. Alright? We'll cure it just now. Just now I'll cure it. Now are you alright? Alright. Done. All right, it's all right. Now you go ahead. She has to work it out a little bit. That's all. But what happened? Something happened in your life? You went to see some guru or someone?
She lost her son, she wanted
to. Where?
This year.
Before that you had it. You'll be alright. You see, this country is very depressive otherwise. For anybody who's spiritual, isn't it, to begin with? Like Modi, I'm telling him to come here, he says, no, nothing doing. I lose my vibration. It's alright. Everything is going to work.
But I have to do something about it.
The fun?
I have to do something because it's not
going. No, it will work out just now. Just now it will work out. Atha thoda sa side la thevati. Tikade. नाही तू आपला हात आहे तिथे आपला हात आहे हा नंतर हिला बसा लुकिंग आउट युअर हँड इज ऑल राईट
माय हँड इज ओके
ऑल राईट नाउ यू कॅन सिट डाऊन देअर पुट युअर लेफ्ट हँड टुवर्ड्स दॅट अँड राईट हँड ऑन द मदर इट विल गो अप जस्ट नाउ नाउ व्हॉट इज इट कम हियर
I'm in a situation with my parental family and conflicts that I feel is very dangerous, and I need both some guidance and also I feel I need protection. And just to give you, it's a lot of power manipulation over money, but both my sisters have become psychotic.
What is?
Both of my sisters have become psychotic, and neither of them were at my mother's funeral.
Your mother too?
Well, no, she died. It was a manipulation, and she died in the spring, but there's just a lot of stuff still going on, and it's very hard to know how to relate to it. So I feel that I need to be involved in...
What are they doing, your sisters?
My sisters are but I consider that it's part of a broader situation where people tried to get money that we were supposed to have inherited. And because it was, they're invalidated in the place of their childhood, you know, with their parents, that it was more than they could handle. But it also feels like a very evil situation. You know, I'm one of my sisters.
Who are these people?
My nephews have kind of taken over.
Nephews, whose children?
And my oldest brother who died. His children had a lot of problems, so you know I think it's all in the family dynamic, but it's just sort of
they are trying to black my
crazy. I don't know. They're trying. I don't know. My brother, he died about 20 years ago, and somehow I think the problems he had with my father, you know, that he didn't resolve, and because he was an alcoholic, he had a lot of problems. His children are sort of playing things out in a way that it becomes. To be evil as a result.
What have they done?
They signed us on to a lot of loans, and then they foreclosed on some property, and you know we have the Internal Revenue Service levying bank accounts for taxes, and it's you know not a situation that can just be avoided. And it's hard to know how to relate to something when you have to do legal things, and you know you feel like that's not really exactly what you're supposed to be doing as a spiritual person, and yet there's really
just beat them with shoes. Write down their names, beat them with shoes. Any problem, beat them with shoes. That will work out. Give them a bandhan, it will work out. Alright?
Okay.
And discuss it with other sahayogis. It will all go into their awareness, it will work out. Don't you worry.
Okay.
Legal is very easy.
It's easy.
Very easy.
Okay, thank
all
you.
Alright? Towards the candle properly.
I have a sahayogini that's living in the ashram.
Now Michael is all right. Yeah, aren't you all right, Michael?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's all right. Premani get
lupa. Premani get lupa. A phone karto ma problem ale matlab problem ala ka phone karto ratri 12 vasta.
Left, there are ala left the problem.
Right.
Somebody has a left problem. If you are kind to that person, then that person sits on your head. If you have a right problem, then pray money. If you are a right person, right-sided, then treat with kindness, mildness. If you are left-sided, be strict. That's all.
Developing.
Yeah. No, you should, for 5 years, you have to be very strict with children. Don't pay over attention. Don't try to show that you can't exist without them. Keep them in proper place. Discipline them properly. But respect. And as they grow, tell them that you are prince. You are great. And you should do this and you should do that. And you should not behave like an ordinary person. You are extraordinary. You are special. But you must behave, first of all. That's the main thing is. Not in demanding things, but how you behave is important. Right? There's a little booklet that has come out for the children. I hope you get that.
Oh.
From London, yeah. They have got.
Oh, that would be wonderful. Also, just one more question is, what do you think about if you have small children going on the tour to India?
Difficult just now. But maybe this year I'll just see what we can do about it. We are thinking of arranging something in Bombay where children can stay with someone till you tour about so that you will be much more free. Might be able to arrange. Yeah, try to come to Switzerland if possible. But best is to come to India. See if you can. That's nothing like it. We'll try to make some better arrangements this time if possible.
Sangana Swamini Mataji Sri Nirmala Devi Ki
Jai.
Bolo Sri Vishnu Maya Sri Mataji Nirmala Devi Ki
Jai.
I've met all of you and I hope you are all very happy with yourself.